Now we calibrate the gable head. Why do we need to calibrate the gable head? First, we draw a 100 by 100 square. Then we mark. I have the black paper. If you don't have the black paper, you can use the dark color paper or a piece of metal instead. We found some problems. First, the lines in our design are straight lines, but the marking lines are not straight, and the size is not correct. It's 110. Our design is 100. We calibrate the gable head in the software. Click parameters. The default field size is 100. We change it to 110. This option we choose gable 2 equals X. This option we choose gable center. Then we will adjust the 8 parameters. First, we will fix the line distortion. We will adjust the 2 parameters. How to adjust the 2 parameters? If our design is a square, if the marking shape is like this, the left and the right sides are convex outward, then we should increase the gable 2 parameter. If the marking shape is like this, the left and the right sides are concave inward, then we should reduce the gable 2 parameter. If you remember, the marking shape is more like this, so we should increase the gable 2 parameter. We increase a very small number, like 0.05. Okay, and mark. You can compare the old marking and the new marking. The left and the right sides are straighter. Now we check the lines with the ruler. They are still a little convex to me. So we need increase the gable 2 parameter. So we should increase this parameter. We should adjust the parameter, then check the marking result, and repeat the process again and again until we find the best parameter. To save time, I skip the process. I have got the best parameter. It's 1.054. Okay, then we mark. We check the left and the right sides. They are very straight now. And we also check the upper and the lower sides. They are a little concave inward. So we need to fix the upper and the lower sides distortion. We need to adjust the gable 1 parameter. The method of gable 1 parameter adjustment is similar with that of gable 2. When the upper and the lower sides are concave inward, we need to reduce the gable 1 per meter. We reduce a very small number, like 0.05. We input 0.95. Okay, and mark. The upper and the lower sides are a little convex outward now. I hope you have understood the method. After some testing, I have got the best gable 1 per meter. The best per meter is 0.978. Okay. And mark. We check the upper and the lower sides. They are straight lines now. We have fixed the line distortion. Then we will fix the trapezoidal distortion. We will adjust the 2 parameters. So what's the meaning? Our design is also a square. If the marking shape is like this, the upper side is shorter than lower side, then we should reduce the gable 2 per meter. If the marking shape is like this, the upper side is longer than lower side, then we should increase the gable 2 per meter. We measure the marking size. The length of lower side is 110 millimeters. The length of upper side is 109 millimeters. Upper side is shorter than lower side, so we should reduce the gable 2 per meter. We reduce a very small number like 0.05. We input 0.95. Okay, and mark. Apparently, the upper side is longer than the lower side. The length of the upper side is 114 millimeters. The length of lower side is 105 millimeters. So we should increase the gable 2 per meter. After some testing, I got the best gable 2 per meter. 0.9954. Okay, and mark. We measure the length of the upper side. The length of upper side is 110 millimeters. The length of lower side is 110 millimeters, so they are same. I also measure the length of left side. The length of the left side is 118 millimeters. The length of right side is 118 millimeters, so they are same. The lenses of left and the right sides are same, so we don't need adjust the given one parameter. Next, we will fix the parallelogram distortion. We need adjust the two parameters. So how to fix the distortion? Our design is also a square. If the marking shape is like this, we should increase the given two parameter. If the marking shape is like this, we should reduce the parameter. We should make sure the four corners of the square are right angles after the adjustment. It's very interesting. I found that the four corners are right angles. So we don't need adjust the two parameters. Actually, my engineer friend told me that you don't need adjust the two parameters for most machines if you don't have very high requirement on accuracy. Finally, we adjust the scales. It's simple. We click the button. The desired marking size is 100. The actual mark size is the length of upper or lower side. It's 110 millimeters. Then we click this button. The desired marking size is also 100 millimeters. The actual mark size is the length of left or right side is 118. Okay, then we mark. Now we check the size of the marking. Is 100 millimeters. Is 100 millimeters. No problem. We finished the calibration.